Hello everybody, Roger Gantner here. Well, this is going to be my video review of M-Series TV by Vizio. It's their new series TV that just came out. As you guys know that subscribe to me, I had a 55-inch LG TV, 3D TV that is, and that TV bought about 2 years ago, bought the service plan on it through Best Buy, and in less than 2 years, the screen went out in it, the touch panel went out in it once, the touch panel went out in it again, and finally Best Buy has a policy, it's called a no lemon policy, and under their protection plan that states, you know, once a item's been in for 30 or more times for repair, they limit it out. And what they did is I bought the DVD or a TV DVD combo with it, was like $1,600 at the time. Had it for almost 2 years. Ended up taking it back to Best Buy the other day. They gave me $1,600 credit. Wanted to stay away from LG, but still wanted the passive glasses. I don't like the active, because, you know, the glasses cost more. And personally, I feel the passive glasses give to a better experience. That's just my opinion. I looked at both of them, but with that being said, this is what I ended up trading for. This TV was $1,049, so I still have, like, you know, after tax and all, like $600 still sitting, being able to use after I bought this TV. But with this TV here, it is a 55-inch. It's, like I said, it's the Vizio's new M-Series. Really nice TV. The 3D quality of this TV versus the LG is just uncomparable. The 3D quality of this TV is just so superb, it's hard to even explain. You'd have to have them sitting next to each other to see what I'm talking about. But, you know, if you're looking at an LG or you're looking at a Vizio and you want something 3D, definitely go Vizio. I think they got the 3D technology down. It's pretty darn good. This is also a smart TV, meaning it has different apps on it. This is a remote that comes with it. I don't know how well you can probably see it, but, you know, on the button here is the app button, or here in the middle is the app button. But click on it. This brings up your little app menu down below. Of course, YouTube, web videos, Netflix, Vudu, Yahoo Sports, MGo. I couldn't figure out what MGo was, so I contacted Vizio, and they told me that it ain't up and running yet, but very soon it will be. And it's gonna be a place that I guess you can rent movies from, like streaming movies. But the nice thing about it, you know, instead of new movies costing $6 or $7, they said it's gonna be like $3 to rent movies through MGo. And on top of that, he was telling me that MGo is going to have the ability to stream movies to you that are like 3 or 4 weeks prior to coming out on DVD. So that will be kind of neat. Of course, it's not up and running yet. The CTV store, that's like your app store. You can download, I think they got 70 or 80 different apps. You know, Pandora Radio. These are just ones that I have installed on here that I use. But that's your app store, or your apps, I should say. You know, if you want to watch Netflix, you would just go to Netflix, click on it, give it a few seconds. And of course, the TV is Wi-Fi, so you don't have to connect it to Ethernet. You can, but you don't have to. And here's your, you know, all your Netflix, which is kind of neat. We can exit out of this, go back to what we were watching just by hitting the exit button, and take this back here. Another thing this has built into it is multimedia. It has two USB ports on there. Also, you have access to, like I have a home server that does DLNA. I have access to that DLNA. So I can click on it. I can go to my videos. And then I'll just go down to my video folder here. And it has all the videos that I have on my server. I can access from the TV. This here is streaming right from my server. I think it's a really neat option on the TV. Because before I had to use either my PS3, and one thing I hate about streaming through PS3, a lot of times it wouldn't let you because the codec wasn't available, what have you. This TV, I've noticed a few movies I have that don't have the correct audio or video codec. But all in all, it plays pretty much everything I have at it. Let's go back. We'll exit out of it and go back to TV. Something else that I like about this TV, it does what they call, it has a 256 QAM receiver inside of it. What's nice about it is my cable company has digital boxes, and with those digital boxes, you know, that's how you pick up your digital channels. For whatever reason, our company does not scramble their digital signal. So therefore, this TV has a 256 QAM receiver in it. It will pick up all the digital channels, which I thought was really neat. Some are high def, some are not. But you know, I think that's something that if I were them, especially with the newer technology TVs coming out, I might want to scramble it, because people are going to stop dropping their cable boxes and getting it for free. We don't watch really enough TV to pay for the cable box. I just happened to plug it in, search for channels, and this is what I found. But back to the TV. The sound quality is something to be desired. Not the best sound quality, but you know, I got surround sound that kind of solves that issue. The next thing is the remote has to be pointed down to the bottom left of the TV is the IR part of it where it receives it, and it has to be pretty much dead on, otherwise it don't change channels. It, you know, if you move it to the right a little bit, like here I just move to the right, it won't change channels. Move it back to the left, it will. Supposedly that's something that Vizio, again, when I talked to the Vizio rep, they're aware of the issue and they're sending a firmware update out to fix that issue. And that's another thing that I like about it is this TV will automatically, they will push firmware updates to the TV. You don't have to go out and try to find the firmware updates. They will push them right to the TV. Another neat feature I like about this, click on menu here. I searched in the box for the damn user's manual for this TV. Could not find it. Well, the user's manual is built into the TV. Yeah, come down here at the very bottom. Click on user's manual. And here you go. This is a complete user's manual for this TV. See, no more losing the user's manual. I guess it's a great idea. Until your TV don't work and then you can't get access to it, but you know, I'm sure you can find it online. Exit out here. And you know, the 3D quality on it, like I was telling you before, is just so superb to anything else I've had. I just really like it. Of course, you could change your screen ratio to widescreen, zoom, normal, panoramic, you know, whatever you would prefer to set it at. Take up the whole screen. And as you notice up at the very top there, it'll tell you the name of the channel on the left, Right next to it tells you the quality of it. This is 480i, so it's a standard definition. The time, the bars next to it show you your Wi-Fi connection, and the next one over shows you the aspect ratio of the TV. Let's see if I can find something in high def here. These are all 10 or up 480. Trying to figure out exactly where the high depths are. I know they're further up here. Here's 1080i. It will do 1080p, but you know, you need something, obviously the source needs to be 1080p. All in all, guys, I think for the price and the money, if you're gonna spend it on a 3D TV, and when you want passive, I guess there's only two that do it, that really do it, I should say. I guess Samsung kind of does it, but the main ones are Vizio and LG. My experience with LG has been terrible. It's the biggest problem is the parts availability for them. So the service center that came out and fixed it, like the first time my TV broke, the screen went out, it took them almost 2 months to get me a screen for that TV. Of course, they probably had to ship it from like Guam or somewhere, who knows, but Vizio, I have one in my basement, works great, I love it, so that's why I went back to Vizio. I think I'll stay away from LG. Of course, it has a guide on here. You click guide, click it again, no program or title information listed. This is in Dolby Digital 5.1 surround sound is the audio output on this. There's not really much more to say about it except for, you know, very good TV. Feels like very good quality. TV only weighs like 51 or 52 pounds. Fairly light, real easy setup, just screwed the stand to it and away we went. But you know, guys, thanks for watching. If you guys have any questions, any comments, feel free to let me know, and everybody have a great day.